Hello and welcome to official Xbox 360 Magazine's OXM report. Now, the 2010 Formula One season kicked off last week, and about a month before that, we headed over to Codemasters Birmingham to have an exclusive look at Formula One 2010 for the Xbox 360. Okay, so I'm here with Stephen Paul from the F1 2010 development team. So you guys, your last game was 50 Cent Blood on the Sand at this studio, and now you guys are Codemasters Birmingham. What's the transition been like for the team going into a racing game now?
I think it's been a large transition. I think the team historically have done a variety of different games, so they can turn their hands to different titles quite quickly, which has been very useful. I mean, especially in something like Formula One that's changing continually, especially at the beginning of the season. I think they're doing particularly well. It's not been an easy transition switching over to a racing game, but I think our advantage has been the fact that you're building on top of the Codemasters technology, so that gives you a huge head start. So I think that's our advantage.
How's it been trying to keep up with the changes in Formula One? Obviously, you guys are producing for the 2010 season, which is the one that will be beginning fairly shortly. Is it tough to produce a game for a season that's going to be underway as the game comes out?
Yeah, it's definitely a bit of a challenge, that's for sure. I mean, we set our stall out. Obviously, a lot of the fundamental basics stay the same. A lot of the circuits are mainly the same. Practice your qualifying, your rules and regulations. So very early on, we were able to get cars on tracks and establish those base rules. But now looking towards the 2010 season, you know, we're only a month away from the race start. There's still a couple of drivers that aren't confirmed. There's still some tracks that are in development. So it has its challenges, but there's no doubt this is going to be the best season in Formula One for many a year. So we're absolutely key to get it all that data in.
F1 has often had a sort of unfair reputation for being boring. I mean, what are you guys doing to make it sort of feel exciting and vibrant?
I think it's been about identifying the things that are exciting in Formula One. In terms of the race, it's certainly the number of cars that are on the track and so on and so forth. And trying to put a bit of personality in the drivers so you feel as though you are slicing and dicing the other characters. When you do overtake them, it's a real moment of achievement. Slightly different skew from other racing games, I think, which is more about the fun in time trial. This is fun of competing against these world-class drivers.
And you guys are really fleshing it out off the track as well. You've got this career mode with you wander around the paddock and you interact with the media and the other drivers. Tell me a little bit about that, how that works.
I think it's just trying to extend the things that we all see on TV. I mean, it's cool seeing behind the scenes in the garages and in the paddock lane and seeing all the media attention that goes on around the world of Formula One and getting some of that into the game as well. So it boosts your career mode. You feel as though the game is watching what you're doing, commenting on what you're doing through the media. You feel as though you are actually playing out a proper career mode rather than a game of years ago whereby you just step through race by race by race. You feel as though people are watching your progress throughout the seasons now.
The game obviously looks gorgeous even at this sort of fairly early stage. What's the biggest kind of technical challenge that you guys have faced during the development of the game?
Getting it to fit, I think, in memory and stuff at the moment. So, track side, you've obviously got 26 car grids, which is a challenge in itself, up from grid and dirt. On top of that, I think we've gone up to like 200,000 people in the crowd waving banners and various bits and pieces. We've got a couple of hundred people who reside in the garage to do the pit stops, all motion captured. Weather, the track data itself stores all the information on how wet the track is, how much water it throws off, the damage of the car. So getting all that to fit has certainly given our coders something to think about.
I mean, you guys have had the input from some of the drivers. Can you tell me a little about who's played the game and what they thought?
Yeah, I mean, we speak to Anthony Davidson, who was in 2009 a reserve driver for Gorn, also their test driver. He gets to work on all the simulators as well, which has been particularly useful for us. You know, one morning he might be working with Braun in 2009 and he was working on the simulator. He comes in and gives us some feedback on what they've been up to in their car handling in comparison to our physics setup. And I think that's quite crucial for us because having the input of a driver and the input of a driver who's in that kind of test role, worked on the simulators and plays a lot of racing games as well, to be honest, is unprecedented, I think, for us. You kind of get that detailed feedback and he understands what we're trying to achieve as well with the physics setup.
And he was saying that a lot of the F1 drivers are gamers and that they're keen on that kind of thing. Are you hoping to impress those guys as much as the regular audience?
Oh, I definitely. I mean, if we're hearing about the fact that they love to set those competitions up between themselves, we want them to be playing our game as well. I think they're after that level of authenticity, the realism in terms of the car handling and the way it behaves on the different circuits. And if we can attain that, go for that goal, then I think it would benefit everybody, to be honest.
Awesome. Guys, thank you very much for talking to us.
No worries. Thanks.
For all the exclusive details on F1 2010, pick up the latest copy of official Xbox 360 magazine on shop shelves now.